And welcome back to my channel for yet another tutorial. This is my Get Ready With Me tutorial featuring the TARDIS Pro Palette. Let's get into it. Jumping right into the tutorial, I'm taking my Paint Pot and laying low. I'm going to spread that all over my lid. Then I'm going to set that Paint Pot with the color Classic in my TARDIS Pro Palette. In my crease, as my transition color, I'm going in with the color Bold. It's a very neutral color. It looks very similar to my own skin tone. Next, I'm going to go right in my crease with the orangey color called Wispy in the palette. You slide on all your nights like this. If you all haven't got your hands on the TARDIS Pro Palette, it smells amazing. I think it smells better than the chocolate bars by Too Faced. I don't know. It smells very sweet. But yeah, I'm just building that color, doing windshield wiper motions until I achieve the color I desire. Next, I'm going to go lower, like right smack dab in my crease with the color Drama. It's like a mahogany color, kind of plum mahogany color. Beautiful. I'm also going to take the product into the outer V corner of my eyelid. Next, I'm going in with a dark purple called Vamp. You guys know this is the key to flawless eyeshadow look. You definitely want to gradually build, blend, and you know, go from lighter to darker color. I'm gonna keep the intensity towards my outer V, that color, and then I'm gonna just swipe it on over to the front of my lid, but I'm not gonna pick up any more product. So next I'm gonna go back in with my Paint Pot and I'm gonna carve out my lid. I'm not really doing a cut crease, but turning out to be that. But I didn't want to go too high up on my lid. I just wanted to help the eyeshadow pop. For my lid, I'm going in with the color Mint. And I'm just swiping that along the Paint Pot. And it's a gorgeous purple shimmery color. I'm just going to pack that on. Now we're going to add more depth to the eyelid because it is date night. So I'm going in with the color Smoke. And I'm just going to blend that and focus that on the outer tail of my eyelid. And just blend, make everything look very seamless. So I don't know, I kind of wanted to do something different, but I'm going in with the e.l.f. liquid liner, and it's a bluish color. It kind of looks very inky, and I'm going to do me a dramatic cat eye. I'm going to take that tail all the way out there. So for my liners, I usually start with the top line first and go about halfway into my eyelid and then go to the front and then connect the two and then clean it up. I'm gonna just, you know, just follow along as best as you can. I typically find that, you know, a wing liner is just difficult, so I don't really have a preference with liquid or gel liners. As you can see, this is, you know, tape helps me out a lot actually, so. But this is basically how I achieve my wing liner, and I'm just gonna clean up that line. Do you slide on all your nights like this? Do you try on all your nights like this? Put some spotlight on the slide. Whatever comes, comes too clear. Now I'm gonna be prepping my lashes with the Roller Lashes Mascara by Benefit. For my falsies, I love this mascara. It really helps curl my lashes all in one way. This is gonna help me put on my falsies. I'm using the Kiss 11 and my dual glue. Boom. Now I'm gonna take my liner and kind of just conceal that strip and kind of fix the other liner to match the previous one I did. Now it's time to serve face, honey. I'm using the Black Radiance True Complexion Primer that's gonna control my oils. Then I'm taking the NYX Concealer Palette in the red, orangey, peachy shade. I'm gonna conceal all my dark marks. Because these concealers are so creamy, I'm using my finger to blend them in, because the warmth of my finger being patted on my face kind of melts the product and makes it easier to blend. Put that spotlight on my face. We gon' pop up and turn up. We gon' light up and burn up. I'm too hot like a furnace. I got a 100 G's, I'ma go, y'all. My diamonds gon' shine when the lights dark. You and I take a ride. Now I'm gonna go in with my MAC Prolong Nourishing Waterproof Foundation and my stippling brush. I'm gonna speed this up because nothing's changed. I do the same thing. If you all wanna see my foundation routine, I will be sure to link it below. I decided to just be extra today, so I'm going to take my Anastasia Concealer in 5.0 and just brighten my highlight. I'm going to take it down my nose as well. I don't know, the Tarte just wasn't giving me enough brightness for this look, so just went ahead and got extra with it. So now I'm going to blend that out using the same stippling brush. Taking my foundation stick in Earth, and I'm going to carve out my contour areas just the same. Make sure y'all check out my full foundation and highlighting and contour routine. I'm going to link that below so you guys can get a better gist of what I do when I do. Gold brow pencil a shot. However, this is like my first try with it, and though it worked, it kind of made my brows a little too oily for me. As you can see, this is really, really not doing well with my skin, I guess. So I'm probably not gonna use it as much. Definitely gonna go back to my previous NYX Flame Tame and or my MAC brow crayon. But I tried to get this drugstore one. It looks flawless. I love the color, but my skin too oily for it. So I'm just going back and cleaning up my brows, because as I go through my foundation routine, they kind of disappear. So I'm going to start, I'm going to do more setting. I'm going to set with the NYX Loose Setting Powder and Naturally Beige. And I set the size of my nose and all of the highlighted areas. Now I'm going in with my Studio Fix Powder and carving out my contour areas. Like I said, it's in my previous foundation routine. I'm going to link below. I'm going to take a fluffy brush and brush off that excess powder. Now I'm going in with my Mineralized Skin Finish in Dark Deep. And I'm going to just put that all over my face so I can have a healthy glow, honey. Now I'm going in with the Black Radiant bronzer in the color Ebony. And I'm going to take a white eye pencil and just line my waterline to open my eyes up even more. I have really puny eyes. Baby, these eyes so puny, honey. Like, oh my god, it be giving me the blues. Like, I don't know, they small and then they have a nerve to be sensitive like that. Like, what? Now I'm going in with the best mascara ever. As you see, I just did a couple sweet sweeps. This Tarte Lash Paint, oh my god, y'all, like, it be doing it, dude. Don't worry, I'm gonna fix my lash. I see it coming up. Don't y'all say nothing about my lash, but I'm gonna do my bottom lashes or whatever and make them all like dramatic or whatever. And I'm gonna show y'all how I fix my lashes. Typically, this always happens. I just take a real fine brush and I take some duo glue and I just put it on there like I'm doing. So it's wet, no, it's not dried. I know like a lot of makeup artists hate putting on wet lash glue on their lashes, but it works perfectly fine because I don't feel like taking the whole lash off. So I'm gonna make it do what it do. And I'm just like stick it on my lashes. Try to stick it on my lashes. Got it. Okay. And now I'm gonna pinch it and, you know, just make sure. Sorry, I don't know why I'd be going out of focus. But I'm just gonna pinch my lashes and make sure they're together. Now it's time to highlight. I'm sure y'all seen this 1,000 times. I did the button of my nose down the bridge and also the apples of my cheeks. I'm gonna finish my look with the lipstick Amore Prohibido by MAC Cosmetics, and I'm gonna set my face with Mario Badescu facial spray with rose water. And here's the finished look, guys. I hope you all enjoy watching this video. As always, like and comment. And most importantly, subscribe to my channel. Until next time, bye.